Hello everyone. Last class we have discussed some beam problems and frame problems by Cassegrain's method. Let us continue with solving few more problems on frames by Cassegrain's method. So here the frame is given with one column and one beam. So they have asked us to find what is the vertical deflection at joint A, the point A. So vertical deflection at A. So first we need to check whether there is a concentrated load acting at that particular point or no in the direction of A. So vertical load, yes, there is a vertical load of 20 kilonewton acting at point A. So whenever you are finding vertical deflection, there should be a vertical load, that is concentrated load, or whenever you are finding horizontal deflection, there should be horizontal load at the point where you are finding the deflection. So here vertical load is there. So what we need to do, so we need to assume this vertical load as P, correct? So in terms of P, we need to find the moments in the regions AB and the region BC. So once you find the moments, then differentiate with respect to the load, that is P, then before integration set it to 20 kN. Okay, so if it is imaginary load, then it's necessary to set before integration only, or else, so in terms of P only you can calculate what will be the deflection. Later you can substitute P is equal to 20 kN. Okay, so here two regions, so AB is one region and BC is one more region. So in AB region, A as the origin and at a distance x you will be finding what is the moment. So in BC region, at a distance x from this point B, as considering B as the origin, you need to find what is the moment. So that is shown in this figure. So in AB region, so at a distance x, A as the origin, by assuming P, the 20 kN is as P, so find the moment. So in BC region, so again B as the origin at a distance y, okay, so find what is the moment. So there are two portions, AB and BC. So moment of inertia in AB region is I. So moment of inertia in BC region is 4i. Okay, moment of inertias are changing, so we need to take care this moment of inertia accordingly. In Cassegrain's equation, m into dou m upon dou p into dx, correct, divided by ei. So ei is there, flexural rigidity, we need to take appropriately 4i. Okay, so AB region, A as the origin. In BC region, B as the origin. Then limits in AB region 0 to 2 meters, BC region 0 to 4 meters. Then moment in AB, okay, so sign convention is remaining same. So cut a section, so rightwards if it is anticlockwise, rightwards if it is clockwise. So this is positive, this is same. So since this road is rotating clockwise, so minus P into X in AB region. So in BC region, load is here, the perpendicular distance about this is this, so that is 2 meters. So P into 2, so again it is rotating clockwise, so minus P into 2, that is minus 2 into P. Okay, so portion AB, BC, in portion AB origin is A, in BC origin is B. So limits AB region 0 to 2, BC region 0 to 4. Moment of inertia, it is I in AB region, in BC region it is 4i. So moment is minus P into X, so in BC region minus 2 into P. Check it once again, here in AB P into X, in BC P into 2, correct, 2P. So now differentiate with respect to the load P. So here minus X, so here it will be minus 2. So write on the Castiglione's equation m into dou m upon dou p into dx divided by ei, so 1 by ei when the limits 0 to 2. So this is for AB region. Okay, so this is for BC region, correct? So 1 upon 4 ei 0 to 4 limits. So minus p into 2 into minus 2 into dy. Okay, so here we need to set p as 20, so before integration, or else continue with p only, substitute at the end. So 20 x square, so again p here 20, 20 into 2 40, 40 into 2 it is 80, correct? So here minus into minus it will be plus, so minus into minus it will become plus. So 20 x square, so integrate it within the limits 0 to 2, 0 to 4. So substitute the values, so ultimately we'll be getting the deflection as 133.33 by ei. So which deflection it is? It is vertical deflection, 133.33 by ei. So similarly, if you want to find the horizontal deflection at point A, so again, so AB region, BC region, two regions you need to consider. Moment of inertia I, so here it is 4i. So 0 to 2 is the limit in AB, 0 to 4 is the limit in BC. Okay, so since there is no horizontal load acting at A, so we need to assume a horizontal load at A first. So what will be the horizontal load? So we need to assume the horizontal load Q. Again, cut a section, so from A, so at a distance x, so from B, cut a section, so somewhere here, and this will be y. So again, we'll see with this figure. So that is in BC region, so 4i, 4 meters, and B as the origin, at a distance y is the section. In AB region, so A as the origin, at a distance x, so the section. Okay, so ultimately we need to find what will be the moment. Okay, so in this, so due to the load q at distance x, there is no perpendicular distance, moment will be zero due to q, and due to p, that is nothing but 20. So we need not to write p now, so I will not use this p, so I will use it as 20 kilonewton now, not p. So p is required when we are finding the vertical deflection. Now we are finding horizontal deflection, so we need not to write this p, you can directly write as 20. So what is the moment? 20 into x, since it is rotating clockwise, minus 20x in AB region. In BC region, due to q, yes, load is there, this is the direction of load, so it is moving like this, this is the perpendicular distance, so q into y, again it is rotating clockwise, so it is minus. If it is anti-clockwise, then it is plus, but it is rotating clockwise, so minus, minus q into y. So again, due to 20, so 20, so it is downwards, 20 into 2, that is 40 in BC region, correct? Check it. So AB region, BC region, in AB region origin is A, BC region origin is B. Limits 0 to 2 here, 0 to 4 here. Moment of inertia I and 4i. So moment, so in AB region, so due to q nothing, due to 20, 20 into x, that is clockwise, so minus 20x, correct? So in BC region, in BC region, so due to q, q into y, this is the perpendicular distance, this is the direction of load, again rotating clockwise, so minus qy, then due to 20, 20 into 2, this will be the perpendicular distance, this, the load is moving like this, 20 into 2, so again it is minus 40, minus 41, and q into y is 1, so check it, minus 20 to 2, that is minus 40, minus q into y. So now differentiate with respect to, so this is not P, so dou m by dou q. It is dou m by dou q, since you are finding the horizontal displacement. So dou m by dou q. So here q term is not there, 0. Here q term is there. So here differentiation of moment with respect to is minus y. Correct. So delta. So for AB region and delta for BC region. Correct. So m into dou m upon dou q into dx. So m into dou m upon dou q into dy. So for AB region separately, for BC region separately, if you write it. So do the integration within the limits. Take care this 4EI. So ultimately you will end up with delta as AT by EI. So delta we are getting as AT by EI. Okay, this is the horizontal displacement for that particular problem. Okay, similarly let us look into one more problem. So a frame with three members. So which are the members here? So one is AB, that is column, then BC beam, then CD. So it is again a vertical member, so but there is no support at D. Okay, total four joints A, B, C, D. Okay, three members A, B, B, C, C, D. So accordingly we need to consider three portions, three regions. A, B is one region, B, C is one more region, C, D is one more region. Okay, so first we need to find vertical deflection. So to find the vertical deflection, what we require? So we require the vertical load acting at point D. So if it is not there, first I need to assume a vertical load P acting at point D. Okay, so once you assume the vertical load P, so in CD region, so start from D. So cut a section from, always take a section from free end. So otherwise if you take from this end, so you need to have all the reactions, vertical, horizontal and this moment. So instead of that, it's better to have the moments at the free end always. Okay, so cut a section here. So consider the distance y. So in C as the origin, consider this as x. So again here B as the origin, consider it as y. So check it in CD region, what will be the moment? So there is no moment due to P, because the line of action passing through the moment center, there is no perpendicular distance. In CD region moment will be zero. So how about in CB region? So due to P, the moment at this section will be P into x clockwise, so minus px. Sign convention, cut a section rightwards, anti-clockwise positive, but it is clockwise, so minus px. Then due to this UDL, so what is the intensity of UDL? 30, correct, kilonewton per meter. So 30 into x by 2. So at the center from this to this, 30 into x is the total load, so which will be acting at the center, that is x by 2 perpendicular distance. So nothing but minus 15 x square, 30 by 2 is 15, x into x is x square, minus 15 x square. 1 is due to P, so minus P into x, minus 15 x square in BC region. Similarly, what will be the moment in AB region? So due to P, yes, perpendicular distance is 3 meters from here to here, P into 3, correct, minus 3 into P, so it is rotating clockwise. So due to 30, 30 into 3 into 3 by 2, so 30 into 3 is the total load, so which is acting at the center. So from here to here, this perpendicular distance is again 1.5, correct, 3 by 2, 30 into 3 into 3 by 2, correct, that will be the moment in AB region due to P and due to this 30 kilonewton per meter. Just check it, the figure again. So section here y, section here x, so this is y. In AB region B as the origin, in BC region C as the origin, in CD region D as the origin. So moment of inertia is constant, then limits CD region 0 to 2, CB region 0 to 3, and AB region 0 to 5. Just check it. So DC, CB, and BA. Origin D, C, and B. Limits 0 to 2, 0 to 3, 0 to 5. Correct? So moments. So in CD region it is 0. So there is no perpendiculars. In CB region, P into X. Then again 30 into X by 2. So minus PX minus 15x square, 30 into x by 2. Correct? So then in AB region, due to P, P into 3. So that is minus 3P. Due to UDL, 30 into 3 by 2. 30 into 3 by 2, nothing but 1.5. Correct? So rotating clockwise. So it is minus. So again, dou M by dou P. So differentiate with respect to load P. So here it is 0. So here it is minus x. So here it is minus 3, the coefficient of P. Correct? So again, we need to have this equation, Cassie-Clunas theorem, according to first theorem. So M into dou M upon dou P by EI for DC span or DC portion, CB portion, BA portion. Total three portions separately, we need to add them to get ultimate deflection at point D where the deflection is required. Correct? So we have assumed the P. So set P is equal to 0. Correct? So P was not there here. So we have assumed the P value. It is a dummy load. Correct? Dummy or imaginary. Correct? Okay. Sorry. Okay. Done. So set 0 before integration. Okay. So again here P is there. Set 0. Okay. So here minus into minus plus 15x cube. So 15x cube integration x cube is x raised to 4 by 4. X raised to 4 by 4. 15. So here it is 0. 135 into 3. So it is 405. Minus of minus it is plus. Correct. So into constant is there. So 1, nothing but y. So within the limits 0 to 5, it is 0 to 3. Substitute the values. So ultimately we'll be getting 2328.75 by EI meters. If suppose if they have given the EI value, so substitute in standard units and calculate what will be the deflection. Okay, so this is vertical deflection. Similarly, if you want to find the horizontal deflection at point D, so here at point D, so we need to have a horizontal load Q. See, here it is not there. We need to assume a horizontal load acting at Q. So let us discuss with the figure only. So here at point D, so we need to have the load Q, horizontal load acting at point Q, acting at point D of load Q, intensity is Q. So in CD region, again D as the origin, cut a section, find what is the moment. What will be the moment in DC region? Q into Y. So it is rotating anti-clockwise, so it is plus. So I will write in CD region, what is the moment? So it is Q into Y. So it is anti-clockwise, so it is plus. So cut a section, I will write it here from rightwards, anti-clockwise positive, correct? So it is rotating anti-clockwise, so it is plus QY. So again in BC region, okay, so this is the section, so C as the origin. So due to Q, what is the moment about this point? This will be the perpendicular. Okay, so I will write the moment in BC region here. So due to Q, so it is Q into 2, perpendicular is 2, Q into 2, then due to this UDL, so it is minus 30 into x by 2, so ultimately it will be minus 15 2 and 15, correct? Minus 15 x square, correct? Minus 15 x square in the region BC. So if you write in BA region, this is important. So here in region, so first due to Q, so what I will do, this y, the portion I will assume more than 2, okay? So this y from origin B, the section is more than 2 meters. If that is the case, what is the moment? So if I assume the load is somewhere here, from here to here is 2 meters, correct? This 2 meters, Q is here. So y is more than 2. So what is the perpendicular at this section? This total is y. So 2 is gone. Remaining how much? Y minus 2. Then how the load is rotating now? It is rotating clockwise. So it is minus Q into y minus 2. Due to Q, the moment at this section will be minus Q into y by minus 2. I hope it is clear. So what I am doing, the section from origin B, the y will be considered more than this 2 meters. Okay, so it is rotating clockwise. So minus, then Q into perpendicular is only this much. Total is y, this 2 meter is gone. So it is y minus 2, that will be the perpendicular. Then again due to this UDL, so minus 30 into 3 into 3 by 2, that is 1.5, correct? Over only this load and this load, just check it. So in DC region, Q into Y, DC region Q into Y. So in CB region, Q 2Q minus 15 x square, correct? 30 by 2, 15 x square, 2Q minus 15 x square, 2Q minus 15 x square, correct? So in BA region, minus Q into Y minus 2, minus Q into Y minus 2, minus 30 into 3 into 1.5, 30 into 3, 90, 90 into 1.5 is 135, yes, correct. So now differentiate the partial derivative of this moment with respect to Q, the horizontal load. So here it will be Y, here it will be 2, here it will be minus Y by 2, the coefficient of Q, correct. So again, the Castiglione's equation for DC, for CB and for BA. Yeah, we have written here. So DC, BC and BA, correct? M into dou M by dou Q divided by E into dy. So this is dx, this is dy. So vertical, we have assumed in columns at a distance y. So it is with respect to dy, dy. Okay. So substitute the values, M is there, dou M by dou Q is there, this column in all the regions. So substitute within the limits. So Q, set Q as 0 before integration, because we have assumed the value Q. It is a dummy load, imaginary load or a fictitious load, correct? Then after integration and substitution of your limits, you will be end up with the deflection, that is horizontal deflection, as 67.5 by EI. So if EI value is given, so in standard unit kilonewton meter square, substitute the value and calculate. So what will be the deflection, the horizontal deflection. I hope this is clear. The same procedure you will be using for all the different types of frame problems. Okay, I hope it is clear. So then let us stop with this discussion on frames. Now we'll start with finding the deflection of determinate trusses by Castiglione's theorem. Okay, so this is in continuation with strain energy method, whatever the problems we have solved in trusses, correct? So again, the truss is a pin jointed member okay, made up of slender members, where the loading will be only at the joints and it can handle only the concentrated loads. Okay, so and the type of force present in the members of the truss is only axial force, correct, either tension or compression. Okay, so similar to the strain energy method truss problem, so we'll be solving the truss problem by Castiglione's theorem. So this is the first problem. Determine the horizontal displacement of joint C. So here at joint C of the truss shown in figure, the cross-sectional area of each member of the truss is 400 mm square. Okay, so AB, BC, AC, three members are there. So all the three members are having the cross-sectional area as 400 mm square. And Young's modulus of elasticity, it is 200 GPa, 200 gigapascal, 200 gigapascal. Pascal means Newton per meter square. So use Castiglione's theorem. So what is ultimately we need to calculate here? So Castiglione's theorem. So the partial derivative of the total strain energy, dou u upon dou p, correct? So if you do it, the partial derivative of the total strain energy with respect to the load, you will be getting what is the displacement, correct? So we need to find the total strain energy stored in the member. But before that, how we have done in case of beams and frames, similarly we need to assume where the deflection is required, there should be a concentrated load, and if the value of concentrated load is given, so we need to assume that as P first. In terms of P, we need to go ahead with the problem. So what will be the total strain energy stored in the trusses? So this is the total strain energy stored in the trusses. So already we have done this. What is this? P square L by 2AE in each member. So in all the members, we need to add them. Summation of P square L by 2AE. Correct? This is the formula to be used for finding the total strain energy. Okay? So how to find this total strain energy? So we need to first find what are the forces in the members in terms of P first. Okay, forces in the members of the truss in terms of P. So 4 kN is there. Due to 4 kN, what will be the forces developed in each individual member? That we used to find normally. But here by Castiglione's method, so we need to assume this as P. Correct? So in terms of P, what is the force in the member AB, in the member BC, in the member AC? Okay, so once you find in terms of P, then the total strain energy stored in the members will be finding with respect to P. If I differentiate, I will be getting what will be the deflection. Okay, so now cross-sectional areas are given. So we need to go ahead with one of the methods. Either you can use the method of joints or method of sections. Okay, any one method you can use, and you can find what will be the forces in each members. The first step, so you need to find what are the reactions. This is hinge support, two reactions, RA and HA. This is roller, that is RB. Vertical reaction at A and horizontal reaction at A. So vertical reaction at B. Okay, use your equilibrium conditions and find the reactions. Then either you can use method of joints or method of sections, whichever you are comfortable. Okay, so while discussing the strain energy method, we have discussed the procedure to be followed in method of joints and method of section. So you can adopt anything. So if you want to find the method of joints, then the condition is, so you need to consider the joint where there are only two unknown member forces are acting. The FVD of the joint where there are only two unknown member forces are acting. Assume the unknown member forces as tensile. Then apply two equilibrium conditions. Sigma H is equal to 0 and sigma V equal to 0. Correct? We will be getting what will be the forces in the members of the truss. Okay, let us see this. So first step to find the support reaction. So we have assumed that 4 kilonewton as P. So we need to find the reactions, that is Ra, Ha and Rb. So if you use the sigma H is equal to 0, so you'll be getting what is Ha. So this Ha is ultimately you are getting P, that is leftwards, Ha leftwards. Similarly, if I take moment about B equal to 0, so Ra into 8, so that's P into 3, perpendiculars 3 equal to 0. So you'll be getting what is Ra. Ra you are getting as minus 3P by 8, or else Ra as 3P by 8, which is downwards since it is minus. So Ra is downwards, not upwards. We have started with assumption upwards, so we are getting negative value, so it is downwards. So then if you apply sigma y or sigma v equal to 0, so Ra plus Rb equal to 0, so you'll be getting Rb as, so minus of Ra, nothing but 3p by 8, which is upwards. So ultimately sigma v equal to 0, so if this is downwards, this has to be upwards. Okay, so now next we need to find the forces in the various members using method of joints. So we'll not spend much time here because already we have discussed and you are aware about how to find the forces in the members of the truss by method of joints. So I can start with my joint A. So I can assume the unknown forces as acting away from the joint. Then similarly here, consider joint A. So these are the reactions. So resolve this into horizontal and vertical component, apply sigma H is equal to 0, sigma V equal to 0. So you will be getting what are the forces in the members. So similarly, consider one more joint, then find what will be the forces in the members. So once you find by method of joints or method of sections, you need to have this tabular column, what we have developed in strain energy method, the same thing. So total three members, AB, BC and AC. Then length of each member. So one thing what we need to understand here is keep all the parameters in standard, okay, or else in one unit only. So always it's better if you can find all the units or the parameters in terms of mm, okay, kilonewton, the load, the length in mm. So AB, so convert into mm, so 8000 mm, this BC is 5000 mm, AC is 5000 mm. So see here, so this is 8 meters, so 8000 mm. This is 5 meters, so 5000 mm. This is, and this vertical is 3 meters, 3000 mm. Correct? So 3000 is not required. So 3 members, AB, BC, AC, 8000, 5000 and 5000. Areas are given, so write down the areas in mm square. So here the areas are given in, yes, 400 mm square. Keep it in mm square, 400, 400, 400. It is constant. Young's modulus, it is given in GPa, giga pascal. So newton per meter square, 10 raised to 9. So convert that into kilonewton per mm square. So 200, 200, 200. So the load. So in each member, after by doing method of joints, you will be getting in AB P by 2, in BC member minus 1.25 P by 2, in AC member 5 P by 2, 5B by 8, sorry. So these are the forces in the members of the truss. So then total strain energy, the formula equation, P square L by 2 AE in each member. So this total strain energy kilonewton mm, okay, so P square, so this P is there, L length is there, 2 into A area is there, and Young's modulus is there. So multiply all the things, divided by 2 AE, so you'll be getting 0.0125 P square. Similarly in BC, 0.0122 P square. Similarly in AC, same. Okay, the lengths are same, area is same, Young's modulus is same. So then load, so that is this. Ultimately, you are getting same value of BC and AC, the total strain energy stored. Okay, for the entire truss member, If I find the total strain energy, then it will be U is equal to summation of P square L by 2AE for all the members. Okay, so if you add them, you are getting 0.0369 P square. Okay, this is the total strain energy stored in the entire truss. So now you need to find the deflection. So what is deflection according to Kashkin's theorem? So it is dou U upon dou P is equal to deflection. Correct. So U is there. So if you integrate, if you differentiate with respect to P, so what it will be? So it will be P square will be 2 times 0.0369 into P. Differentiation, partial derivative of this term will be P square is there. So we are differentiating with respect to P. So it will be 2 times 0.0369 P. Correct. So the same thing, delta C is dou U upon dou P. So we'll be getting 2 times 0.0369 P. So the P value is 4 kilonewton. So delta C is 2 times 0.0369 into 4. So ultimately you are getting 0.2952 mm. Okay. So this is the deflection at point C. So this is how you are going to find the deflection in case of trusses by Kashkin's theorem. So let us look into few more problems on trusses and discuss. So one more problem on truss. So this is a cantilever truss ABCDE is hinged at two points A and E. E is 2 meters below A. EDC is the horizontal bottom chord, C being the free end, ED is equal to DC is equal to 2 meters, AB is equal to BC. BD and BE are the vertical and diagonal members. The truss is loaded with 20 kN loads at point C and D. Cross sectional area of each member is 8 cm square. Find the vertical deflection of the free end C of the truss using Kashkin's theorem. Take Young's modulus E is equal to 2 into 10 raised to 5 megapascal. Okay, so a cantilever type of a truss. So where this particular truss is hinged at point A and point E. Then again AB is equal to BC, the lengths. So this is bottom chord ED and DC. So they are same, 2 meters, 2 meters. Okay. So the loads are acting at point C and point D. So 20 kN, 20 kN. So we need to find what will be the deflection that is at point C. So vertical load is there. So what will be the vertical deflection at point C? We need to find. So there is a load. So what we need to do? So we need to consider this as P. So whenever you come across a cantilever type of truss, so it's not necessary to find the reactions, not required. If you are going ahead with method of joints, it is not required because you can start with point C. So if you consider joint C, these two are unknowns. You need to consider a FBD of a joint where there are only two unknown member forces. So if you consider joint C, the force in the member BC is unknown, the force in the member CD is unknown. Two unknowns, two equations, you will get it. So then you can consider joint D. So CD is already known, force in the member BD is unknown, force in the member ED is unknown. Then you can consider joint B. So this is known, this is known. So you are left out with AB and BE. So you will get, so those two with those two equations, sigma H is equal to 0, sigma V equal to 0. You can always start with the free end in case of cantilever type of truss. It is not necessary to find the reactions. Directly you can start with method of joints. But while finding the method of joints, again when you consider FBD of joint C, so you need not to consider this as 20 kN. You need to consider it as P. So ultimately the force in this member in terms of P you will get. This member, and also this member. In all the members, the forces will be in terms of P only. Correct? So here the areas are given, so they are given in centimeter square, so convert into mm, okay, mm square. Ultimately Young's modulus is given, so MPa, so again convert into kilonewton meter square, okay, millimeter square. So we are converting kilonewton into millimeter square. So now step one, to find the support reactions may not be required this step. So directly start with the finding the forces in the members by method of joints. So one by one, so you are already aware about how to find the forces in the members of the truss by method of joints. So consider joint C. So we have assumed P, not 20 kN, it is P. So in terms of P, you will be getting the forces C here, minus 2P or 2P, so 2.23P. So consider joint D, FBD of joint D. Then assume the unknown forces tensile. Then find what are the forces. Consider joint B. So the similarly, once you find all the forces, again the same tabular column. So member length, area, Young's modulus, P, and energy stored. So total six members, the lengths. So in mm, the area in mm square. And Young's modulus, kilonewton per mm square, correct? So kilonewton per mm square. So in standard unit, in case of conjugate beam method, moment area method, we have considered as kilonewton per meter square and moment of inertia as meter is to 4. The product EI should be kilonewton meter square, the standard what we have found. So but here, so in case of trusses, always convert into mm. So it will be better to find the deflections P in kilonewton. So see here, all the forces are in terms of P. Then ultimately the strain energy kilonewton mm in terms of this. So if you add all the members, strain energy stored for the entire truss will be something like this, P square one term. Okay, in terms of P one more, and in terms of constant one more. So apply Castiglione's theorem. Next step, so delta C is equal to dou u upon dou P. So differentiation of this, it is 2 into 0.1192 into P. Differentiation of this, 0.696. This it is zero, correct? There is no P term. So this is the value, the deflection. So P value, now you can substitute, that is 20 kN. So then you are getting ultimately the deflection at point C, that is 5.464 mm. Okay, 5.464 mm. So similarly, one more problem. So that is again it is a cantilever type of truss only. The cross-sectional area of the members is as indicated in the figure. So find the vertical deflection of joint C. So here, yes, there is a load acting vertically. So we can find what is the vertical deflection. Young's modulus is given. So in terms of mm, so kilonewton per mm square, use Castiglione's theorem. All the lengths are given. Then again, you can find what are the angles. Then by method of sections or method of joints, you can find what are the forces in the members of the truss. First, you can find what are the reactions. So go ahead with this. Step one, find the support reactions. So this 40 kiloton, first you need to assume it as P. Okay, so once you assume the P, then in terms of P, find all the forces in the members of the truss. So use equilibrium conditions. So then find the forces in the members by considering FBD of each individual joint where there are only two unknown member forces are acting. Correct? So you are aware about this? Yes, ultimately this tabular column. So total members are seven members. The lengths are in mm. The areas are in mm square. Young's modulus is in kilonewton per mm square. The load in kilonewton. So if you can observe, all the member forces are in terms of P. The strain energy stored in each member, okay, in terms of P only. At the end, total strain energy stored in the entire truss, summation of p square l by 2ae. So you are getting 0.0872 p square for the problem. So if you apply the Castiglione's theorem, so delta c is equal to dou u upon dou p. So here it is 2 into 0.0872 into p. Okay, so now if you put the value of p, so that is 40 kilonewton, so delta c will be getting it as 6.976 mm. This is the vertical deflection. Okay, so this is the procedure, so to be used in case of Castiglione's theorem. So let us discuss once again. So what we have done, so first we have considered the point where the deflection is required. So whether there is a load, vertical load acting at that particular point or no, or else a horizontal load acting at that particular point or no, we'll check it. If it is there, we'll assume that only as P. If not, we need to assume it as a fictitious load. Then in terms of P only, we need to have all the member forces. Then we need to find all the member forces by method of section or method of joints, then formulate this tabular column, okay, in terms of mm, then apply the Castiglione's theorem, you will be getting what is the deflection. Okay, this is with respect to Castiglione's method, where we have found the deflection and slope in beam, and horizontal and vertical deflection in frames, and the deflections at the loaded point in case of trusses. Okay, so let us stop it here. So in next class we'll start with unit load method. Thank you.